remote file inclusion, similar stuff like that. So where is it? Yeah, here is this. So today I'll show you one thing, okay, how you can set up Burp Suite. That's one thing I'll walk you through with the steps that you need to set up a proxy tool, Burp Suite. Let me open Paint here. So first of all, let's talk about proxy. What is a proxy? Proxy. What do you understand by proxy? Any idea?
Intermediate between client and server.
Right, intermediate between client and server, right. So on the left hand side, you can see that I have made a client. Okay, that is on the left hand side. On the right hand side, I have created this server. Okay, so first of all, let's talk about normal scenario. What happens when client tries to communicate with server? What happens? Let's create it with the red color. So a request is sent from the client to the server. Okay, that's how a request is sent, and the response is sent back from the client to the server, from the server to the client. Okay, so okay, that's how your request and response looks like, right? In this direction and in this direction. Right, guys? That's how normal request and response goes. Right. Now, what happens when we introduce a proxy is, let's say I introduce a proxy in between. Okay. So this is my proxy server. Now, what happens is this proxy server is going to sit in between of these requests. Okay. Let's create it here and let's name it as proxy server. Oops. And now the requests are going to be sent like this way. First, the request is sent from client to the proxy server, and then the proxy server forwards the same request to the target server. Okay. The server is going to reply back to the proxy server, and then the proxy server is going to send the request back to the client. Okay, that's how. Oops. Let's. Yeah. That's how your requests and response are going to look like after setting up a proxy. Okay, now what is proxy is basically when in case of normal request, when this request in that is in red color, when this arrives at server knows that who is making this request. Okay, server knows that you are making the request. This is the client that is making the request. Okay, but in case of this proxy, when the request is being sent from proxy, server does not know that client is making the request. Server knows that this is the device which is making the request to me, from me. Okay. I hope this thing is clear.
You mean if anyone uses the proxy will change the IP or something?
Yeah. Proxy is going to basically, you can say, it's like many times you would have heard about bypassing certain restrictions, like certain websites are not allowed to be opened from your ISP
Yes,
or websites are blocked in your country.
blocked, yes.
Right? So what you do is you basically try to use some proxy websites, like
Hotspots.
let's say Hide My Ass is a very famous proxy, HMA. Okay. It's a proxy website. So what happens is, let's say I'm going here and I'm trying to use this thing.
Mean the VPN or something.
A VPN is something different. Okay. Let's not get confused with the VPN. Let's just stick back to the proxy. Okay. Let's say, okay, there is no surfing available here. Let's search for something else. Hide my ass, hide my ass. Nope, nope, nope.
For hotspot shield, it's also proxy.
I've not heard about Hotspot Shield. Proxy, why proxy products that workspace is there? No. Let's just search for proxy website. Hidester is one. Okay, so what I can do is I can, let's say, just type google.com here and click on surf anonymously. So I'll be presented with the Google homepage. Okay. Okay, so I'm able to search google.com here, but now my IP address is not being revealed to google.com. Okay. Instead, the IP address of this Hidester servers are going to be revealed to google.com. If I'm sitting from the Google side, if I'm talking about the server side, the server is going to feel like the request is being sent from hidester.com. It does not know that I am sending the request. I am the one who is behind this thing.
Okay.
Okay. That is basically your proxy.
Okay. So you mean it will hide your identity.
Yeah. Right. So it is basically sending request on your behalf.
I think the hacker, they are using this techniques, because if you follow them, you
Sorry,
cannot.
the hackers have.
They are following these kind of things because, if you just follow their, if you just check them, you cannot find them because they are changing IP or something. They are coming from different IP.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right, let's get back to my Kali machine over here and let's talk about
But by the way, what's the difference between proxy and VPN?
sorry.
What the difference between VPN and
VPN is
proxy?
going to encrypt your traffic. On the other hand, proxy does not encrypt your traffic. Okay. Now what we are going to look here is we are going to set up a proxy tool that is basically known as Burp Suite. Okay. Burp Suite. Very famous tool. And what we are going to do here essentially is simply this is going to be my system. Okay. And I'm going to set up my proxy tool inside this own system. Okay. Let's change the shape. This is my Bob's foot. Okay. Now what is going to happen is the request is going to be originating from my browser and it is going to be sent to the Burp Suite first of all. Okay. And then that Burp Suite is going to send that request to the target server. Okay. Oops, not this diagram, something else. Then the request is going to be sent to the target server through the Burp Suite. Okay. And here you can imagine any server.
So the web source is the proxy, as you said, right?
Sorry?
The web source is a proxy, making the proxy or
No, Burp Suite. We are going to set up a proxy for
what?
Burp Suite. Okay. Why we
Okay.
are using Burp Suite is we are using Burp Suite to intercept the request. And the requests which are originating from my browser. I want to capture them. I want to see them. I want to edit them. So I will be editing them, capturing them in the Burp Suite tab. That's what I'm going to do. Okay. So the response is going to be sent from the server. The response is going to be sent from the server to the burp suit. Okay. And then the burp suit is going to send the request, send the response back to your browser. Okay. That's how it is going to work actually. So this is your request being sent from your browser to the burp suit, from your burp suit to the server, server sending back the request to the burp suit, and then burp suit sending that request to your browser. Okay. So let's check it out practically here. Okay. So what you can do is simply go here and search for your burp suit tool here. Simply click on it, open it.
It's a predefined tool.
Pre-installed tool.
Yes, okay.
It's a pre-installed tool. I just searched for it. I'm waiting for it to open. So let's click on close, click on next. Click on start burp.
You start the session run before I came or since long time?
I'm simply starting the burp suit from here. So go to the proxy tab. Once going to the proxy tab, you need to go to the options tab. And what you are going to see here is, you see details here. Okay.
This is your IP, right?
This is the IP address where it is listening. Okay.
Okay.
So now what I am going to do is, I'm going to go to my browser and set up proxy there, some change some proxy settings there. Going to the browser, let's see. After going to the browser, let's go to the preferences. In preferences, you need to search for proxy here. Go to the settings and click on manual proxy configuration. After clicking on manual proxy configuration, you will see that there are no entries here in your browser. It is going to be blank. You need to enter 127.0.0.1. That is my loopback IP address.
Okay.
Basically, that's the IP address of my own machine.
Okay.
And the port number here, the port number on which my burp suit is listening basically. Here you can see that it is listening on this IP address on this port. So what I'm doing here is I'm just trying to tell to my browser that whatever traffic you are going to send, send it to this IP address on this port.
Okay.
So I'm just going to enter these values here, 127.0.0.1, port 8080, and then click on use this proxy server for all protocols and click on OK. Once I clicked on OK, what I need to do is go back to my burp suit. Go to your proxy tab, intercept tab, and see if this button is on or not. It says intercept is on. Okay, good. If the intercept is on, okay, cool. Now let's.
Before it's not on, right?
Sorry?
Before that, it's not on. Before you make the configuration, right?
It was already on. By default, it's on.
Okay.
When you are going to start burp, by default, it starts in the intercept on state.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah.
So in this way, normally you open all the blocked websites. I mean, by doing this same.
Blocked website?
I mean, some blocked website. You
no,
cannot
no,
open.
We are not doing this for blocked website.
Okay.
I'm not doing this for blocked website. I already told you that I am doing this thing to start intercepting the request, I want to see what requests are leaving my browser. I'm not saying I'm not doing this for unblocking any website.
Okay. Yeah.
Is this thing clear?
Yes.
Yeah. So go back here. You need to type here demo.testfire.net. And when you enter this URL in your browser, you will see your Bubsuit is going to pop up. And it says that this request has been intercepted. And you can see here, the request has been actually intercepted here. Okay, this is the request. This is the HTTP request.
Okay.
That has been intercepted. Okay. So now what I can do is I can decide if I want to forward this request or I want to drop this request. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to forward this request. Click on forward. Forward, forward, forward. And once I forwarded all the requests, you'll see that my website is open now. Okay.
Okay.
So what happened here? What happened here? Can any one of you explain this to me?
The website was not open. Then you forward, then the website was open.
Why my website was not opening initially?
Because the traffic was intercepted to proxy that buff suit, not to the server.
Yeah, right. Because the request never left my system. It left my browser and it was captured at my Bubsuit tool. Okay. That's why I was not able to see any response. Okay.
After forwarding it went to that server.
Yeah. When I clicked on forward, then only the traffic went to the server and I received a reply back. Okay. That is basically the very basic functionality of proxy tool. And what you were able to see is you were able to see what request was being or generating, what request was being generated by that website. Okay. To see that request, to read that request and to modify that request. That's why we have set up our Bubsuit. That is our motive, to read that request and to modify that request, to play with that request. That's the motive here. Okay. So now let's click on intercept on. Now what you guys need to do is you guys are going to observe that I am only able to intercept HTTP traffic. I'm not able to intercept HTTPS traffic. Okay. So for that, what you need to do is you need to open this website, okay. http://burp. Okay. This is something that you need to open. Let me just click on intercept off. When I'm going to set on intercept off, burp is not going to stop any request in between. Burp is simply going to forward that request to the server. Okay. So let's get back here. And from here, you need to click on this CA certificate and you need to download this CA certificate. Click on OK, click on save file and click on OK. Okay. Once this certificate has been downloaded, what you need to do is you need to install that SSL certificate in your browser. How are you going to install that certificate in your browser? You need to go back to your preferences in your browser and search here CA, or let's just search for certificate here, cert. Okay. And click on view certificates. This is your certificate manager. Basically click on here and click on import. After clicking on import, go to your downloads directory and select the certificate that you have downloaded. Click on it and click on open. Okay. So I've already installed it. I'm not going to click on open then. You just need to click on open and the certificate is going to be installed. Once the certificate is installed, you can try going to google.com and you will see that google.com is working now. Otherwise, it would have, as it is an HTTPS website, it would not have been opening in your browser.
So if you download this certificate, you will open this HTTPS and also HTTP, both.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So now this is how you can set up your burp suite for intercepting HTTP as well as HTTPS traffic. Okay. Now let's talk about very basic functionality of burp suite. Okay. Let's click on intercept on. And let's say, let's go to some website. Let's go to any website here. Nope. Let's go to forward test PHP. Do we have any test PHP dot Wollen web? .com. I went here, okay, and you can see it's a, is it a HTTP link? Oh, we don't care about that. Let's just click on intercept on. Okay, now let's go to, let's say, your profile. So if I'm going to start navigating this website, you will see that all of the requests are now going to be intercepted here. Okay, I can click on forward and it is going to open the web page here. Let's go back your profile again, click on forward. Forward. Okay, so the web page is being opened here. Let's just divide it into two halves. Now let's try logging in here. Okay, let's say, let me just type here Michelle in the username, and in the password let me just type admin in the password and click on login. When I clicked on login, what you can see is this is the request that is being originating from the website and it is not yet sent to the server. Instead, the request is sent to the burp suite. Now what I can do here is I can see that the values that I entered here are being visible to me.
I remember the social engineering, the tool. If you enter the file, you will see the file directly.
Tool for social engineering?
Yes. In social engineering, we use the tools. I remember the ngrok tool.
No, this is not the same thing. This is something else.
Okay. But you show me the value once you enter.
Yeah, so that was your credential harvesting.
Yes, yes. Okay.
Where we hosted a website and we sent it to the target. When the target entered the credentials, we were able to see those credentials. Okay.
Okay.
In this case, everything is happening on my own machine. Okay. I cannot send this page to you and you enter your credentials and I will be able to intercept it. That is not possible here. Okay. I can only intercept the traffic at my local host. That's all.
Okay.
So, okay. Now, what are you able to see here? What is this?
Show me the language for this web page. Show me the link. The DNS. And show me also the user, the credential, the username and password, the values, I mean.
Okay. Anyone else would like to try?
Also show you your machine details. and your browser.
See, essentially what I am able to see here is the HTTP request. But if I need to be very specific, you can see that this part is known as your HTTP header.
Yes.
Okay.
This is the header.
This is your HTTP header, protocol header. And let's just go here. Let's go to google.com and this HTTP header. Let's go to images and let's try to see how does a HTTP header looks like.
It's not like HTTP header.
So this is how your HTTP header is going to look like. Yeah, no, every protocol is going to have their own header, right? No, okay. Two protocols are going to have same header. Why are you saying that it is going to be similar to TCP header? It is a different protocol. HTTP is a different protocol. UDP is a different protocol. ICMP is a different protocol.
Okay.
Different protocols have different headers. And this is how your normal HTTP request header looks like. Okay. You can see here. This is your request header and this is your response header. You can see here the host, that is the target website to which the request is being sent, the user agent, that is the information of the device, the client information, whosoever is trying to fetch the resource. Okay. Let's go ahead. So what I can do is I can try manipulating these information over here. Okay. I can try to simply forward this request. Other thing what I can do here is I can try using some other tabs here. So one more thing that you need to observe is this page has not yet been loaded.
Yes.
Right. This is still loading. Right. You can see here. This request is not being, this request has not yet been sent to the server. Let's get to the buff. Now what I can do is I can click on action and I can send this request to the repeater or the intruder. Let's send this request to the intruder. Let's go to the intruder tab. Okay. In the intruder tab, you need to go to the position tab. And what I can do here is I can send a lot of requests using intruder. You can see that I can try brute forcing certain value using intruder.
Okay.
Yeah. So let's see. Let me just click on clear so that clear all the parameters. Now let's say I want to do brute forcing here at this point. Okay. How can I do a brute force here? So first of all, what I need to do is I need to enter these credentials as the variable here. Okay. Just mark them, select them and click on add, select them and click on add. So I have added them as a payload. Okay. You can see here at the bottom, it says to payload position. The first one is this and the second one is this. First position is this and the second position is this. So let's click select the pitchfork. What pitchfork is going to do is I'll tell you just in a while. Let's go to the next payload tab first of all. Okay. So here it says you need to enter your payload set. So basically here I need to enter the word list that I want to use. Okay. So I can just provide with some random words here. Okay. Like let's just provide admin password creds. Okay. And let's say test. So here you can see the payload counts are set to 7. These are your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay. These entries. Let's go to the second option, second payload option. And let's enter some values here. 1, 2, 3. Let's just enter password. and something something and something something, and let's just enter test. Okay, so what I have did here is basically to understand, to help you understand, is I entered two word list. Okay, there are two word list having some random values, right?
Okay.
Some random values here, and there's another word list which is also having some random values. Okay. So the first word list is going to be considered as the payloads for the username, and the second word list is going to be considered as the payload for the passwords. Why so? Can you tell me why so?
Because you have two payloads for username and password.
Yeah, because I have mentioned them. I have selected this payload position that
yeah.
Whatever I am going to provide in the first word list, it is going to be sent here. This is your first word list place, and this is your second word list place. That's why. Okay. And I went here. I set some values here for the first word list and the second word list like this. And in the attack type, I selected pitchfork. So what pitchfork is going to do is basically, when you have more than one entries here, what pitchfork is going to do is, pitchfork is going to take, is going to try to brute force serial number wise. Okay. Like it's going to take first word from here. This is going to be its first attempt. Second attempt is going to be this. Third attempt is going to be this. Fourth attempt is going to be this. Okay. And fifth attempt is going to be this. This is what pitchfork basically means. Okay. Like for the first attempt, one credential for the username and another credential from the serial number one from the first payload list, and the serial number one from the second payload list is going to be taken, and it is going to be tried as a username and password.
Okay. So you are supposed to be like put like random numbers and random values, and the pitchfork, it will try all the username and password you as you enter, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
So let's click on start and let's check it out what happens here. So here you can see that it is taking payload 1 and payload 2, and it is making an attempt. Okay. And you can see here all of these status codes are 302s, 302, 302. Okay. But in case of test,
200.
In case of test, it was 200. And basically the test credentials are the right credentials. That is something that is going to allow me to have access to the system.
Okay.
Okay. I can try the same thing. Let me show you. Let's go to my proxy tab and change this value here. Let's just type test and test here and click on forward. So that you can see what is happening on the browser end. Let's click on forward, and you can see that I have logged in.
Okay.
But initially I entered the credentials as Michal and admin. Those are the credentials sent from the browser, but I manipulated the request in between and sent something else.
Okay.
Doubts. What is not clear?
So you mean, you are trying to open some website, you are just imagining some password and some username by default, and the tools will try to enter all the possible words and possible password. If it's not found, so it will give you error, right? If it's not able to enter, it will give you error.
Yeah.
Okay.
That is one utility. So Burp Suite is essentially used by web application penetration tester to perform a lot of different types of penetration testing. Okay. So,
but what about if the website of this website making the password too much complicated than the username also? How can you try this kind of penetration?
So then you would not be able to brute force it. Simple.
Okay. So you mean this is for the weak website, the normal website, the easy website, like, you know, like in one page, two page, you can enter this website and you can try. But this is not the secured website, the big website. You cannot do this option, by the way.
Burp Suite is not an attacking tool, Michelle. It's a testing tool.
Okay.
How can you tell a website is secured or not? By testing it, na? You cannot just say it right away that it is going to be only used against secured website or it is going to be used against some less secured website. That is not a right statement. Okay.
Okay.
So this is basically used for testing the website. Like, what kind of vulnerabilities exist there? Am I able to do a brute force here? Am I able to do a login brute force here? I can be testing it for cross-site scripting or SQL injection type of vulnerability. Cross-site scripting I have already talked about in previous session. SQL injection I am going to talk about in the next session. Okay. So a lot of web application bugs can be tested using Burp Suite. Okay. That's the purpose of Burp Suite. Okay, so actually what happens is, this is just CEH, okay? Just an introductory course. There's a dedicated course. I believe you have already opted for the whole training, right?
Yes, for me, I already.
So there is going to be a module known as Web Application Penetration Testing. A whole 1 month training, okay?
In detail, they will give us the option, right?
They are going to give you the option.
Okay.
For what? For what option you are?
No, I mean, they will give us the details, all the tools they are using in penetration, website penetration, right? Like these tools, we will use it also in the penetration, website penetration at that.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, so they are going to talk about OWASP top 10 there, okay?
Okay.
OWASP top 10 vulnerabilities, and there this Burp Suite tool is heavily used, okay? Because your web application penetration testing cannot be done without Burp Suite, you can say. It's like very essential part of web PT.
Okay.
Okay.
So you mean we have two model, why we should take it in this NCH? Already there is a separate model for that. Like, you know, mobile penetration and also web penetration.
So there, those things are covered in very deep. Okay, but
yes.
Yeah, here they are covered at a superficial level, okay? Like an introduction, like something like this exists. So
okay.
That you guys are aware of that, okay? Something like this exists. Now that depends upon your interest, like in what field you want to expertise, in what field you want to move. You want to move towards the network pen testing, you want to move towards the web application penetration testing. What is your field of? Yeah.
Okay.
VH allows you to understand that thing, like where
today,
to move next.
Today our topic is a proxy or what? Or this is a big...
Sorry?
What's our topic today? It's a proxy only.
What we did today?
No, what our
topic? It's a Burp Suite. It's Burp Suite. For Burp Suite to work, we set up a proxy.
Okay.
Yeah. You can say that Burp Suite is a proxy tool.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the next class, we're going to take SQL engine.